Gas chromatography is a chromatography technique used for the separation of volatile compounds. Volatile compounds are the compounds that get easily vaporized at room temperature. Let's see the components of gas chromatography. The column used in gas chromatography is very long and arranged in a coil. The column used in gas chromatography are of two types. Number 1, back column, and number 2, capillary column. Back column can be made up of glass or stainless steel. The length of this column can vary from 1 to 3 meters and has an internal diameter of 2 to 4 millimeters. The capillary column is made up of few squads. These columns are very long and have length from 10 to 100 meters and have an internal diameter of 0.1 to 1 millimeter. The column is placed in a chamber so that a uniform temperature can be maintained. The stationary phase is packed in the inner wall of the column. The stationary phase is made up of silicon grease or wax, which can withstand a high temperature. The mobile phase use is usually an inert gas like helium or unreactive gas such as nitrogen. The mobile phase gas is kept in a cylinder which is connected with the column via molecular sieve. The molecular sieve separates the unwanted hydrocarbons, oxygen, and water vapor that may interfere with the test sample during analysis. At the end of the column, there is a detector which detects the sample. Let's see the working of gas chromatography. The sample which is to be separated is mixed with an appropriate volatile solvent such as heptane, acetone, or methanol. Just before the column, there is a septum that allows injection of the sample. The temperature of the injection region is kept 20 to 50 degrees Celsius high as compared to the column. This allows rapid volatilization of the sample. Once the sample is volatilized, it passes down the column where the separation occurs. During analysis, the temperature of the column is kept between 150 to 300 degrees Celsius. Separation occurs based on the interaction of molecules between the mobile phase and the stationary phase. The less volatile molecules interact more with the stationary phase and move slowly, while the more volatile molecules interact more with the mobile phase and move fast down the column. Once the separation is completed, the detection is done with a detector attached at the end of the column. One of the most common detectors used with gas chromatography is flame ionization detector, or FID. The flame ionization detector has three inlets, one for the carrier gas which comes from the column and the other two for hydrogen and oxygen. The igniter ignites hydrogen and oxygen to produce a flame. When the sample molecules reaches the flame, they get ionized and the electrons are released. Across the flame, there are two electrodes, each with a positive and a negative charge. The electrodes detect the electrons generated by the ionization of the sample. Electrons are detected in the form of current, which is amplified and detected by the computer. When the sample is detected, the computer gives a peak with respect to the retention time of the sample. The area under the peak gives information about the concentration of the sample. If the concentration is less, the area under the peak will be less, and if the concentration is more, the area under the peak will be more. Now, for the detection of unknown samples, we need to have standards. Let's understand this with an example. Suppose we run methanol as our sample and a peak of methanol is obtained at 5 minutes. Next, we run acetone as our sample and the peak of acetone is obtained at 3 minutes. Next, we run unknown sample and we get this chromatogram. Now, using information from the standards, we can say methanol is present in the unknown sample, whereas acetone is absent. the remaining peak is still unknown as we do not have any targets to compare its retention time. Perform gas chromatography, often called GC, we use a gas chromatograph. A gas chromatograph is an instrument with a long column filled with small particles coated with a very thin layer of an adsorbent. This layer is the stationary phase of the column. Helium runs through the column and is the mobile phase. A sample injected into the gas chromatograph is instantly vaporized in a heated injection chamber so that the components are in the gas phase, and then it flows through the column. The helium is the carrier for your sample. This technique allows us to separate volatile organic compounds based on their physical properties and determine relative amounts of product yields. Coupled with a computer library, GC can also be used to identify organic compounds.
To run a GC, you first need to prepare the sample for injection. Using a small syringe, collect between 1 and 5 microliters of the sample in the syringe, followed by 3 to 4 microliters of air. Be sure that your sample is free of drying agent to avoid clogging the syringe.
Once the sample is loaded into the syringe, insert the needle into the GC injection port. You will feel resistance as you insert the syringe. Continue to insert the needle through this resistant material, called the septum, until the glass is flush with the injection port. Be careful not to bend the syringe. You can now inject your sample into the gas chromatograph. When you inject your sample, make sure to promptly plunge the syringe without bending it. It is necessary to ensure that the entirety of the sample is injected at one time.
At the same time you inject the sample, turn on the chart recorder. Make sure it is recording by checking the chart paper feed. If there is no paper or the paper jams, contact the TA for assistance. Wait until the entire sample has run through the column.
While the sample runs through the column, clean the syringe that you used to inject your sample. Pull a solvent such as methanol into the syringe. Then empty it into a waste container to clean it of any remaining sample.
When you are finished, turn off the chart recorder. Feed the chart paper to remove all chromatograms from the chart recorder. Cut with scissors.